Welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Neeraj Agarwal and I am Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management, Punjab University, Chandigarh. I am presenting lecture on module titled Supervisory Functions in F&B Outlet. Under the paper titled Food and Beverage Service Operations and Management. After completing this module, the learners would be able to understand the concept of supervisory position in hierarchical framework, explain the various jobs, duties and responsibilities of supervisors, define the supervisory function in food service operations. It helps to list down the activities performed by supervisor in food service organization. It helps to find out the scope of role of supervisor. Firstly, to start with, introduction. The category of staff in the middle part of an organization chart is known as supervisors or captains. This category fills about 15% of total number of staff. Their main responsibility is to supervise their lower staff and communicate them the decisions made by the top level management. A supervisor's captain may be defined as getting work done through people. A supervisor or captain is a person who is responsible for the quality performance of his subordinates with the right to recommend employment, promotion, demotion, discharge, and other personal actions. His job is to ensure that the work is completed in time in accordance with the company's policies and practices. Supervisory function is an essential activity performed by the supervisory staff to check if all the tasks of F&B service are carried out according to the standards set so as to satisfy the customer and make them feel that they have received the money's worth. Now, we are going to discuss the supervisory functions in food service operations. A supervisor or captain should be dynamic and challenging so that he can handle all types of situations. A supervisor captain has to plan the task and organize the workforce available. He has to organize in a feasible manner to see that they are utilized properly for the effective achievement of departmental and in turn to organize the organizational goal, as the main job of supervisor captain is to get work done through team effort. The job emphasis falls on human factor. The interpersonal demands of directing subordinates towards high productivity, quality and quantity standards dominate their work life. A supervisor or captain's role and responsibilities are numerous and complex and require a unique blend of economical, technical, administrative and personal skills. A supervisor captain's role is vital in an organization. They have to perform a few important tasks such as briefing, monitoring, tips handling, training, staff scheduling, and reports generation. Now, we'll discuss in one by one. Briefing. All wage staff are expected to attend the briefing in proper attire and conducted by the supervisor prior to the service. During the briefing, the supervisor verifies the personal grooming of staff to ensure the wait staff is in acceptable condition. Care should be taken that while attending the guest needs, the waiting staff also builds the image of the restaurant. Therefore, the following things must be checked by the supervisor or captain. That is, properly trimmed and combed hair, proper shave as per the guidelines, properly trimmed nails, jewelry should not be excess, well-polished shoes, black socks or whatever permitted, well-polished nameplate, properly washed and ironed uniform, good health and not suffering from any kind of cold or contagious disease. The other important task performed by the supervisor or captain through this activity are as follows. Number one, keep motivating the staff to perform in a better way. Second, attendance check and find out the reason behind the absenteeism. Third, give the special instruction for the day's operation. Fourth, emphasis on discussion on menu for the day. Fifth, enhancing the staff's knowledge about the complete menu. Sixth, informing about the items which are non-available for the day. Seventh, if any item is to be promoted in the outlet, they needs to be explained. Eighth, discuss the problems or any mistakes in the previous operations. Ninth, give solution or suggestion to the staff to make the operation smooth. 10th, allocation of the job responsibilities to be done for the particular operations. 11th, briefing time may be utilized for the training of the staff. 12th, feedback may be taken to improve the performance. Briefing is one of the best opportunities to interact with the staff members to discuss about the operational activities. This key point time must be handled very efficiently by the captain to develop the sense of team building, as it is very important to create the cohesiveness among the team members. If any kind of personal dissatisfaction exists, it must be tackled very efficiently by the supervisor or captain. Checking mise-en-place and mise-en-scene. Mise-en-place means keeping everything required in readiness for service, which comprises list of activities. Mise-en-scene refers to keeping the area clean and presentable. These activities are carried out prior to service. It is the responsibility of a wait staff to carry out all the activities to an acceptable level. The head waiter prepares duty rota to show the assignment of tasks to staff. Handling of tips. Tips are the amount given voluntarily by the guest at the end of the meal or function to the service staff, appreciating their good work. In most hotels, tips are taken only by the service staff and not shared with kitchen staff. In the outlet, where tips are pooled and then distributed periodically, supervisors have an additional responsibility on their shoulders. The best way to perform this task efficiently is to be transparent. While fixing the points to staff members, follow the organizational's tips policy and take the acceptance of the manager and the staff. Following points should keep in the mind by the supervisor or captain. The captain ensures that all the money received as tips is collected in a box. The total amount is counted and entered into tips register after the operations. The tips are distributed according to the points. Each staff member is given fixed number of points depending on their seniority. The total money received during the week is divided by the total number of points that the staff members have. This amount is entered into the register and the signature of the staff is obtained against the name. It is the duty of the captain or senior captain to see that the distribution is fair and justified. A supervisor captain has the authority to consider the request for advances and loans. Stock taking. The supervisor must maintain the stock of all area under his or her control. It should be taken periodically at least once a week, especially during weekdays when the business is lean. This work should be assigned to a team of or 3 staff in rotation. It is also known as the physical inventory and is entered in the prescribed format of the organization. It is not necessary that every time the department or outlet gets back the closing stock as it opens. Few of the items like cutlery may be missing, crockery or glassware may be counted as breakage, and linen could be worn out while handling in the operations or in laundry. The outlets, especially outdoor catering, suffers a lot by this way in the operations. Requisitions. The requisition for supplies required during service are raised by the senior steward and approved by the supervisor, which are obtained from the stores. Supplies in the service area includes edible and miscellaneous items. Edible supplies are sugar, proprietary sauces, salt, pepper, butter, and the miscellaneous supplies includes paper napkins, doily papers, straws, placement mats, toothpicks, etc. No material from any department or area should be collected without requisition for proper control and costing purpose. It is the responsibility of the supervisor to ensure the restaurant is stocked with adequate supplies that are required for mise en place and mise en scène. Staff scheduling. A supervisor or captain must be aware of peak days and rush hours to do the staffing accordingly. Forecasting, busy schedules and staffing accordingly is the key to success. Few points to be kept in mind are as follows. The schedule should be displayed well in advance, at least 2 or 3 days before. Staff distribution should be optimal, that is, maximum staff with most efficiency should be scheduled on peak hours. Holidays should be evenly distributed throughout the week with the same number of people on leave each day except on rush days. Staff should be rotated in each shift weekly or fortnightly depending on the situation. To facilitate proper rotation, equal number of people must be present on each shift as far as possible. Any special request for holidays or shift should be granted as far as possible without affecting the operations. Whenever necessary, overlapping should be done during the peak hours. Supervisory functions ensure smooth operation of any organization. These functions vary from organization to another. Supervisors or captains are expected to guide the subordinates towards the attainment of objectives. Sales analysis. This is the most important function of a supervisor or captain. The supervisor or captain must analyze the sales at the end of the day, week, and month in order to be aware of the following. 1. Actual sales and budgeted sales. 2. Fast-moving dishes. 3. Dead dishes. 4. Average revenue per waiter. 5. Least revenue generating waiter. 6. Most preferred tables. 7. Slow-moving dishes. 8. Components of total sales. All information can be obtained by touch of a key from the computer, provided computerized system is followed. However, it can also be done manually. Information taken from the sales analysis is important for taking various decisions and to know the sales level. Cost analysis. Cost refers to expenses incurred in producing and for serving goods. In food service, it includes all expenses that occurs right from procurement of raw material to washing the soiled plates of the guest. Every employee should be committed towards containing of costs so as to earn more margin of profits. There are basically 3 types of cost. 1. Food cost. 2. Labor cost. And 3. Overhead cost. Now, food cost. Food cost is the cost of ingredients involved in the preparation of dishes meant for sales. In food service business, store issues ingredients against the requisition to the kitchen for the preparation of dishes meant for sale as well as for staff meals. Following is the formula used to calculate the food cost. Food cost is equal to opening stock plus purchases during the month minus staff meal plus value of complimentary dishes served plus closing stock. Opening stock, value of stock in the stores in the beginning of the month. Purchases during the month, value of the food materials procured during the month. Staff meal, value of ingredients issued for making staff meals against requisition. Value of complimentary dishes served. Value of complimentary dishes served can be calculated referring to the standard recipe or cost sheet. Closing stock, value of stock in hand at the end of the month. The food industry generally keeps the food cost in between 30 to 35% of total cost. Labor cost is the cost of labor, which included all expenses incurred for the welfare of the employees in cash and kind. Other than that, salary and wages, cost of staff meal, accommodation, transportation, medical expenses, training costs, etc. will come under the labor cost. The food industry generally keeps the labor cost in between 20 to 25% of total cost. Overhead cost is the expenses other than food and labor. It includes the cost of water, gas, electricity, telephones, postage and stamps, rents, interest, depreciation, etc. The catering industry generally keeps the overhead cost in between 20 to 25% of total cost. Thus, the total cost may be calculated as total cost equal to food cost plus labor cost plus overhead cost. It is important for the supervisor or captains involved in the food and beverage service outlet to keep in mind about the components and subcomponents of total cost. Once the supervisor or captain is efficient in balancing all these parts of cost, then only he could find out the appropriate profit from the sales. Handling complaints. Success of food and beverage operations is ensured when the needs and expectations of the guest are met. Guest prefers the outlet where the complaints and related issues of catering are solved efficiently. It is the duty of the supervisor, captain, to resolve any kind of dissatisfaction caused by the guest. Good experience by the guest not only repeats the business, but it also multiplies by various factors. Complaints from food and beverage operations are basically of two types. One, food related. Second, attitude related. Food related complaints are caused when the expectation of guest does not meet in the food is going to be served. These may be related to portion size, quality, wrong temperature and texture, wrongly presented, unbalanced elements of the ingredients in the meal preparation, wrong taste, etc. The related issues must be defined to the kitchen department for the corrective actions. Attitude-related complaints come under the second category, which are associated with the staff behavior. Poorly groomed personals, ignorance, arguments, delayed service, tips, demands, etc. are these kind of issues which generally shows also the casual attitude of supervisor or captain in the food and beverage service outlet. It needs the corrective action required by the training of the new as well as old employees. Many of the times, the supervisor implies the punishment to rectify the attitude and behavior of the employee by various methods, as reduction of points and tips, shifting of the duty, allocation of other shifts, etc. It is the responsibility of the supervisory staff to analyze the root cause for the complaints and accordingly take the required set of actions. All complaints made and action taken should be recorded in a notebook. If the supervisor, captain in outlet, is strict in job, would experience the minimum level of complaints. Training the staff. All employees of an organization must be trained continuously so as to deliver the products and services as per the standards set by the organization. The requirement of training for an employee must be identified by the supervisor or captain. It may be felt by various ways, like frequent guest complaints, poor performance and low level of productivity, breakages, lack of interest in job, accidents, wastages, frequent absenteeisms, etc. Every hotel has a training department to train the staff to excel in their job. It is the job of the supervisor to schedule the training for his subordinate by coordination of the training department. Training fills the gap between the current performances of an employee to the performance level expected from him. Regular training results in improved performance and high level of productivity, confidence, increased level of guest satisfaction, repeat customer, low staff turnover, high level of job satisfaction, increased level of interpersonal relationship, etc. Managing discipline. Discipline is the hallmark of a good hotelier. Following are some general guidelines to maintain a disciplined team. Ensure that there are written houses, rules and codes of conduct. Motivate staff to follow rules. A fault committed must be checked at once. Always be disciplined, set an example in front of juniors. Now we are going to discuss about standard operating procedures. A standard operating procedures, SOP, is a set of written instructions that documents a repetitive activity followed by an organization. The development and use of SOP are an integral part of a successful quality system, as it provides individuals with information to perform a job properly and facilitates consistency in the quality of a product or service. Writing a SOP. SOPs should be written in concise, step-by-step, easy-to-read format. The document should not be wordy or over-lengthy. SOPs should be written with sufficient details so that anybody with limited experience or knowledge can successfully reproduce the work when unsupervised. These SOPs should be made available for reference. SOPs should be periodically revised to keep them updated. Every organization has its style of writing a SOP. There are no ideal or correct formats. Following is a sample format. How to write a standard operating procedure. Use job titles and not name of people. Follow a logical thought process. Start each step of the procedure with the action word, for example, lift, pour, etc. Use graphics and visuals. Sentences should not be long and complicated. Avoid ambiguity of words, that is, double meaning or confusing words. Now, I will summarize in the module the role of supervisor in food and beverage organization or outlet was defined. The supervisor fills about 15% of total number of staff. Their main responsibility is to supervise their lower staff and communicate them the decisions made by the top level management. A supervisor or captain may be defined as getting work done through people. A supervisor or a captain is a person who is responsible for the quality performance of his subordinates with right to recommend employment, promotion, demotion, discharge, and other personal actions. We also explain the various activities performed by a supervisor in food and beverage organization. The supervisor ensures that the work is completed in time in accordance with the company's policy and practices. An understanding of this chapter will help to perform the role of supervisor in food and beverage outlet and prepares the standard operating procedure for jobs related to F&B organization. Thanking you and have a nice day.